Hello and welcome to this review of toons.ai. Now you can see here that I've got something that you didn't see in the video, and that's because no matter how many times I try and get it to work in the video, this text just doesn't seem to display in the video. I'm going to start by talking about a negative in this review of toons.ai, and that is there are a few bugs. So if we go to preview, you can see in the preview that the text comes along here, it displays, it's absolutely fine. But when I go and render that, the text is not in the right place. And so it's nothing to do with layers because this text is at the top. If I go and move the basic shape to the top, it obviously blocks everything out. But so it's nothing to do with the layers. There simply is a bug. I wanted to talk about a bug before I did anything else because I've got so frustrated in trying to sort out this review video. Bugs in this type of thing are to be expected and hopefully they get resolved. So let's talk about prices and packages for toons.ai, because recently Paul Poner, who makes the software, has taken the approach of not really doing any upgrades. In his last few products that I've reviewed, you paid one fee and there were no upgrades. And I think that has advantages and disadvantages. I hate the upgrades. I hate going through all the upgrades and all the upsells when you actually purchase something, but obviously it does make it more expensive. If you just want a cut down version, then you can get this from $49. In many ways, I think probably the cut down version is fine for people. You've got 5 minute length per video, whereas in the bundle, the more expensive version, you've got 10 minutes. You've only got 40 actions per character in the lower version, but probably that's enough for people. And you've still got music, but you don't get things like upsells like the elite upgrade, the agency upgrade, the monthly releases in the video player and the leads finder. But I don't really know what all those things do, if I'm honest. I've not been able to find a clear thing of what they do. You get faster video rendering apparently, but I don't know what that actually means in practice. Now, don't forget that on both packages, you get a 30-day money back guarantee. Now I am going to say that this video is not sponsored. I paid for the bundle deal with my own money, and previously I've done a first impressions video which you can see using the card in the top right hand corner. So toons.ai is slide based, so I'm going to add a new slide, and it's also very template based. So we can just introduce some scenes ourselves through these templates, which is actually what I've done in building this introduction video. So let's say we want to think about a presentation. If I click on presentation, I get some presentation slides, and I don't get a great deal, but I get some, and they are a starting point. In a similar way, if I want an introduction to my video, I can click on this intros, and you can see this slide I actually use as my first slide. So we've got lots of built and ready-made scenes. We've even got cartoonish ones, which are going to be cartoon based ones here. So we've got some infographics and they all look very good. So we can start by just using pre-made scenes. Equally, if I go back to the dashboard, we can see that we can start by using a template. So here are templates, and we can break into the categories here. We might want a travel one, and we have both 16:9, square and horizontal. So these are quite good, these templates. They do a lot of the work for you and you just alter things as you need to. You can also build your own character, and I'm not going to go through building your own character today, but you can build a character and then access it in your own projects. So I'm going to go to create, and I'm going to start on a blank slate. Like I say, we've got horizontal, square or vertical. I'm going to go for horizontal, and we're back into the editor, although it's not the project I was just in. So we have backgrounds, and what's nice about backgrounds is we can upload our own. We can use cartoon backgrounds, we can use stock footage backgrounds, we can have animated backgrounds, or we can go for a simple color or a simple gradient. I think it's also worth saying that toons.ai isn't just cartoons. You could easily make explainer videos, headless videos and faceless videos that aren't anything to do with cartoons. So I think in my first slide I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to go back to cartoons. So I might want a business background. So effectively, this is stock footage or stock images from some form of stock website. I don't know where these are sourced from, but I know if I click that, I'm going to get a nice background. And I'm quite happy with that. We've got textures, which I think is quite good. These look very fresh and innovative. I would use these myself. We don't get a huge amount, and we also can't search for them. So this is going to be our background, and there doesn't seem to be any sort of effects we can put on the background. Like, we might want a blur, but I can't seem to do that. I put this in and I change the color to white and I change the opacity. I still can't go and add any blurs in. So I can put in sort of a side pane down here. You know, that might be quite a useful way to do this. That, and then I can put some things on top. That might be really sort of a nice touch. And we've got everything apart from the background has align tools, which I love align tools. They save you so much time fiddling about. Yeah, I can't put any blurs in, and that's something I'd like to see for something as powerful as this. So let's talk about animation. We have entrance animations and exit animations. Now, I might want this to slide in from the left, but when I go to exit animations, I might want it to slide to the bottom. Let's have a look at that preview. So that slides in, and at the end, it will slide out. Now, you can't change the duration of the animation. The animations are fixed. There doesn't seem any way to change the duration. I don't think that's the end of the world, but for some people, it might be a deal breaker. So we can add in text. And what's nice is we've got these sort of cartoonish ones, and we've also got these pre-made titles, which are going to save people a lot of time, or we can just add a heading or a subheading. So I'm going to add a pre-made one, and it's going to be this one. I have to go up here. So I'm going to go up here and I'm going to change this to, so that one's going to be big, and this one's going to be G, and the last one's going to be video, although they're not really appearing the way I would have had them appear. So I can't move these up. So this one's actually video. So that is confusing, that the way they display doesn't really match what's on screen. And again, this comes back to the thing about bugs. You can get around this because you can remember this for next time, but I don't know. It does seem a little bit buggy, and some bugs will get resolved and some bugs will always be there. So we can add text. And again, because this is animated, it has its own in and it has its own out. If we want to shorten or lengthen the duration, we just drag things along. And so I can reposition this here and I can make it longer or shorter. Up in this corner, I've got the length of the slide. So if I double click, I can change the length of the slide. Let's change it to 8 seconds. So this mark here is where the slide finishes. So this shape is not going to drop out, because we're going to get to the end of the slide before we see that drop out. And I can move that along and you can see that changes up there. So I'm going to put it back to 8, and this I'm just going to shorten so that it drops out before the end of the slide. Now we've got characters, and I'm going to come back to those characters. We've looked at shapes. What I also like is we've got these shapes that are not your typical shapes, things like quotes, which I think are quite useful. So I might want a new slide, and I might want a background which has a gradient. I might want something like this. And if I go back to my shapes, I might want to do a quote slide. So very easily, I can click here. I can upload an image. I don't know whether that will reside in the category of quotes if I upload something here. Equally, it looks like we can search here, but I wouldn't know what these are called. So I need to know what they're called before I can start searching. So actually, I think it searches across all shapes rather than the ones we're interested in. Go back to our quotes. And let's put a quote in here. So let's be really vain and make a quote about myself. So I'm just going to do this as for my channel, and I'm just going to break that up, and we're going to have white color. That'll be nice. And we're going to stick it in here, and we're just going to make it nice and big. Here we go. They don't have any effects, so, or entrances. So both are going to be left entrance. Let's have a look at this. And it comes with sound as well. So with sounds, we get our sounds and we get text to speech. Let's copy this and put this into text to speech. So I'm going to paste in what I want to say. Down here, I can pick if it's standard or wave. I can pick gender and the country. And if I click generate voiceover, I get 5 for the United States male. I'm just going to pick this one. So I'm going to click add to media. So that's made TTS. Now I've got to find it. So I need to go to uploads. And this is my TTS. But let's just play this.
Hello, how are you?
Okay, so I've clearly picked the wrong one. That must have been one I made before. So I'm going to add this one. So I need to delete this layer. And that's one of the things, it's not very clear which is which if I go to my uploads, because they're just given random names.
Making videos about making videos.
So that's okay. But like I say, TTS 232, it doesn't tell me much. And it goes down the bottom when I would have expected it to go up the top. So some things are frustrating with this already, but we might want to add some background music, or we might want to add some sound effects. So these all seem like background music simply because their duration is quite long. There's 201 and I can keep going through them, but I don't know what they're like or how good they are. So while it does contain background music or a library of background music, I don't know which one I like. You can't search for them and there doesn't seem to be any sound effects. If I want to upload my own background music, I can. I click on this background music button. And I can go and upload, and I'm seeing the same lot of music here. I can also record a voiceover. So if I click here, I can start and record a voiceover. Big G Video, making videos about making videos. Oh, do like and subscribe. So I got a countdown that I could use, which was quite good. And it just records in the browser. So I'm going to click save to uploads. And so if I go to uploads, I'm guessing it's going to be this one.
Doing it with a heavy bop.
Nope.
Let's get this stuff. Making video. Hello, how? Making videos about.
So unfortunately, I needed to refresh my browser, or I needed to refresh so I could see this recording here. And unfortunately, I lost my project. I lost where I was, even though I'd already clicked on the save button. So this is my voiceover. Big G Video. Making videos about making videos. Oh, do like and subscribe. So I can click on that and I can introduce it here. Now I put in two parts to that, so I might want to do some splitting. Yeah, so you can do splitting, but that seems a bit problematic unless I'm doing it wrong. It goes back to those bugs we talked about at the start. So I can add images, and these are images from stock, and I can search for stock. So this is about video. So let's have a look at what we've got for video. I might wish to add this, and it adds as a layer that I can resize. That's useful. Search videos again, and again, exactly the same thing. I can add videos. Got align tools, transparency, and we've got video volume, which we can turn down. So now I'm going to go back to the characters, because I've already made my own character here, which we can bring into the video. And here's the character, so we can scale him up, etc. We can add speech to the character, so we can apply any of the speeches that we've made to the character. So I'm going to give him this recording, and I'm going to give him an action of talking. Now we have quite a lot of actions here for my own character. I want talking. It looks like it's done alphabetically, so I've got to scroll through. You'll notice these things are a bit slow to load, which is unfortunate. It's unfortunately talking is right down the bottom. It's under talk. I'm gonna make all these things not visible. Just make them nice and big, and let's try this again.
Big G Video, making videos about making videos.
Oh. Now again, I'm pretty sure I hid that video, but it seems to have appeared anyway. So yeah, I don't know if I went and rendered this, if it would come out the way I want it to. I'm starting to feel not confident that it would actually. And one of the last features we've got is watermark. So we can upload a logo and it's going to watermark. It's going to stick the logo in. I've not done that. The other feature we have is AI content generation. So I'm just going to click video production services. Now this took around 20 seconds to get some content in my last video. Oh, and that's much quicker. So if I type something in, then I get some AI content, and this can be useful for putting scripts together, but there isn't anything I can do with it within the application other than maybe I could put it into TTS. So I could edit it and put it into TTS, but it just gives me an idea, a starting point for sort of my script if I want to give this a script. We can also have multiple characters on at the same time. So here we are, here's my character and the lady, and we can move them about, and we've got all these actions that we can do. Interestingly, the actions seem to load much quicker for her, so she might be sat down typing, and we seem to have this color deck where we can change the colors, so we can go and make her skin like that if we really want to, or we can change ethnicity. I don't know why we would want to go for green in our basic colors, but in our advanced colors, nope, that doesn't seem to do anything. So yeah, and the last thing we can do is we can set transitions between slides. So obviously on the first slide you can't set a transition, but between the first and the second you can. So you've got all these transitions. They're not marvelous, they're nothing like fades, they're just sort of things that go over the top of both slides. When we export videos, what's quite nice is if I go to my videos, when you create a video, you can see the progress. You don't have to wait a long time. It renders quite quickly, and then you can just download it. You can share them as well, so you must have some inbuilt hosting. But one of the key things is you can see I've rendered this video three times because I had that bug where things weren't displaying in the video. So let's talk about alternative products. So the big alternative product that comes to mind is Powtoon and Animaker. Now those are clearly much more expensive. They're, I would say, premium products. I've actually done a review of Powtoon. You can see that in the card in the top right. Now you don't get these bugs in Powtoon. You get more assets and more things, but in all honesty, I think toons.ai has enough. I don't think you'd be stuck wanting characters or, you know, different effects. I think the assets you get are fine. Maybe the music's not that great and you don't get sound effects. The other alternative is something like Steve AI or Pictori. And with Steve AI, you just type out a script and the AI apparently generates either a character driven video or a stock driven video. With Pictori AI, you type out a script and the AI generates a stock based video. So in conclusion, what do I think? I think this is a good product. I think it is good value, and I think you can dip your toes into this and make nice explainer videos for $49. I'm not really sure what the premium package gives you. I think I'll be looking into that and doing my own review of the premium package. The only downside is there are lots of bugs. Now, it might be those bugs get resolved. It might be as the product matures that the bugs get resolved. However, I can't say with any certainty because I'm not from the company. They've not told me anything because I've not raised any bugs with them. So there may be some bugs and they may be there for some time. So if you can live with the bugs and you're doing very simple explainer videos or character videos, then I think this will be absolutely fine for you. The templates and the pre-built scenes are also a very welcome addition. Thank you. Goodbye.